nice and dry. Whoa, cool. Oh, that thing's haunted. Sure of it. Cool. What's that? Wheelbarrow.
They all a gig of me. Hold on.
Jungle Superman. Jungle Superman. Jungle Superman. I live in a tree.
Tarzan and the Beast, they all a dig of me.
I got a box of 45's at the auction. I wasn't going to get them. I started sorting them up there while I was waiting. Got a box of Hot Wheels. This one had the Batmobile on it, so I bought it. Saved the other one for somebody else to buy. A couple pieces of glassware. They were on in this box. Whoa. I paid a couple bucks. I'm going to put maybe a couple bucks a piece on the glass. See if I can get rid of it at the flea market. I bought it. I kind of like this little bowl cup thingy. I might not keep it. I don't know. The other, I got a little box of cards. couple bucks. Luigi's Pizza. Macro. I got a Fred. Cindy up there, she just came from Florida finally. She gave me these two girly candles. I wasn't sure what she was talking about. We got the Wienermobile. What else we got? There's so Shaggy. Shaggy. Don't know. What is it? Light the fire within. No, it's not the cornflakes guy. Corny. And got Daphne. No Adama. No Scooby. Little blue bottle for Vicks, of course. I don't know what this little, could be a salt dip. It's kind of big. Cindy also gave me this paper mache train tunnel. That dish was in there. I bought Stewie. I didn't notice that his head's slightly dented right there, so there's probably nothing I can... Oh, he's working. Nice. I'm going to try to bathe him, see if I can get him looking a little better. He's got a lot of spots and dirt. He's probably worth 20 to 30 bucks. I paid 9 for him. I think that little girl's going to buy him. I should have let her have him, but... Oh, well. I ended up getting the Drew Carey as played by Dana Carvey. I guess. That's not a very good likeness. Whose line is it anyway? No, it's a Drew Carey show. I waited for this Paul Simon Graceland 25th anniversary. It's 4 CDs, a book, a poster. It's a little scuffed up. I don't know what it's worth. I got to end up getting a lot cheaper. I bid $5. Nobody bid against me. I have a feeling I could have got it for less. But, yeah. Goodbye. I don't know if I'm going to listen to it all or not. I may listen to it. Got this little tote of 45 records for $2. Just kind of like the tote. It's kind of grubby. It's a Capital brand. I liked it because it's not typical square one. It's a silent running cube. You like that reference? I put a couple in the front that I got out of this box, but still got to go through them all. That's what I'm going to do, waiting for my buddy to come play some golf. And then you'll see the rest of the video in the house, whatever I got from Salvation Army. What did I do? I rearranged my camera again, messed it all up. This is actually Tuesday. I'm doing my auction stuff, the rest of it. I guess I already filmed some last night. I had some stuff from the store yesterday in town, but I filmed it, so I'm either going to cut away right now to it. In here. It's going to be at the end of the video. I did get a couple things at Goodwill. Two records today. Might as well just do them to get them over with. The Maddox Brothers and Rose. I think I looked this up before. I think it's been down there. But it's got an orange sticker, which I thought was new. And Smokey Pleacher. A couple of his albums seem to be highly priced on eBay, but I don't know. I got them anyway. I got a few things at the Salvation Army. Not a heck of a lot. And then, I got these three records. Pink Panther, Fred Weller, or Freddie Weller. You think it's the same? It's Frank Weller that did the voices too. And Julie London, Yummy, Yummy, Yummy. I may listen to that album. I haven't listened to the last couple I found of her. And then I got two cops. I don't know, this was the early 2003 Playboy mug, so maybe somebody will make me a couple bucks off it. And then this is one of them, Howes from the 70s. This is Big Daddy. I didn't look on Terapeak, but I looked in Complete. I didn't find a lot. There's several versions and a lot of names on these. I think I should be able to get 20 bucks, I bet, for a Big Daddy. Okay, Big Daddy. And I got a few shirts, which, I don't know if I'm keeping any of these yet, because I can't even remember what they were. Hopefully the sound is okay, all my fans are on, and I got Saga playing in the back. I like that band. I may have to look for some, I'm hoping I'll find some other albums from them. But I got this one, that's been up there for a while. I'm going to wear it, see if it fits good. Maybe I'll wear it. Kind of kiddish, I suppose. And then I got, there was a couple I was going to get, and I ended up not picking them up. Here's a McDonald's. Figure I can get at least $3 for this McDonald's. It's got a black hat and everything on. I may wear it. Trick Treat Win, Dr. Pepper. And then last, this one I'm selling, this dragon one. And it is a Magic the Gathering shirt. So I'm going to put this out probably for $5. I don't think I looked it up. I can't remember. I don't remember if I put in these records. There was a box of records, and Al left them, maybe I did show them already. Al left them in the, he slid them over to me after nobody bought them, and I bought the 45's. Just walk off, Tom. No one cares. Oh, that was Saga. It's playing, if you can still hear it. I lowered it quite a bit. These are the two records I got from that box of junk records. This guy, I don't know. It looks like a folk band, so that might be alright. I think the other members of the band might want to be showcased on the front. I'm a little too far over now, ain't I? Yeah, let's mess it up. And this was the other one. Translator. If you like 80s, early 80s transitional bands, pretty good. Good guitar. The first song, I didn't really like the vocals to it, or the lyrics really, but then kind of grew on me, and it's kind of like, you know, if they want to do their own thing back then in the 80s new wave style. But check them out if you, they're probably on YouTube. I'll probably keep it because the record has a little warp or something at the end. I think it kind of made a little, well, my needle rides low. I'm hoping to get the new one on, and I have not yet. And maybe that's all it was doing because it jumped a little bit. What else did I get from the auction? A little record case. Seems like, I will be right back. I will not be back on the couch. I guess that was it. I'll check and make sure I showed everything in the van when I review the footage from last night. And I guess, unless something else pops up, I will see you in the next video. Thanks for watching, and maybe leave me a like if you see fit. Share, or tell people that you found this terrible video channel. So, probably going to give my daughter this shirt. She really wants it. I told her I'm not done looking at it yet, so it'll probably hang there a while longer. So, we'll see you later. Bye! This ending is just for people that probably want to see what 45s I saved out of that box. This is all that made it through the cut. I have a pile that's mostly rock related. Maybe I'll put them in something and chart, see if I can get $5 for them. And then there's a bunch of random stuff. There was a few things. I looked up quite a few of the ones I wasn't sure about, and I didn't find anything great. A few dollar records. I saved, there was a couple in here, but now I do not know which ones they were now, because I mixed them all up. There's several I want to listen to, and some sound cool, so I want to listen to those, and some of this might end up on my later videos. Green Door, I always want to put this first, one of my favorite songs, Jim Lowe and the High Fives. The Cramps redid this song. And I found three more by the Cox's Auction, Al Cox, the Jeff's father, from his recording studio in the 60s and 70s, Jan Carroll. It's most all country, like I said previously. I've never found anything real super like rockabilly or anything, but one of these days, maybe. Jerry Lee, and She's Gone. No relation to Jerry Lee Lewis, I don't think. Probably the person who wrote the song, Jay Lilly. So most of these guys wrote their own music. These are both by Carroll, Jan Carroll. I don't know if that's a man or a woman, because I've never listened to any of them. Bill Shawrow, Memphis, and was written by who? Chuck Berry. This might be all right. Hank Williams, Darling, I Could Never Be Ashamed of You. And then the rest is just Jim Croce, Gold Diggers, Lover's Cross, and You Don't Mess Around with Jim. Probably just want to listen to it and they'll go in the flea market stuff. The Ventures, Summer Love, Theme from a Summer Place. Band of the Hand, Bob Dylan. I'm going to listen to this, then it'll be for sale at the flea market. I don't think it has a lot of value. I didn't look it up. Hot Butter, those are the ones that did like the, the synthesizer stuff, Popcorn, Percolator. That's going to be fun to listen to. This was really rough. I almost didn't keep it. I'm going to see if, once I clean, if I feel like ruining my needle some more. Ring Dang Do, Sam the Sham and the Pharaohs. And the other side is Don't Try It. And then we got on Star Records. I looked this up. And I don't think it was. I either didn't find anything on this. Warm and Easy Feeling, written by V.J. Breckenridge, and the West Texas Highway, writer V.J. Breckenridge, side one, Columbus, Ohio. It looks like it could be 70s to 80s. They have the whole phone number, but I know there's no date. Pretty cool. Whiskey River, also written by them, so that's kind of cool. I think I looked on Discogs, didn't find anybody, but I'll have to redo it. I don't know. It was getting late by the time I got through most of them. Timmy Brown, I've Got a Secret, and Baby, It's Okay. I believe I looked this up. Wasn't worth anything, so I just saved it because I wanted to listen to the sound, see how it sounds. Folkways, Verb, Backdoor Man, The Blues Project, and Violets of Dawn. Don't know anything about that. Jungle Superman by the Individuals on Red Fox Records, not the Red Fox from Sanford and Son. Billy Gray's The Shag, I kept that just a list too, it wasn't worth anything. BJ Records, Wade Fleming's, I thought this might, see this is getting into the ones I may list, I don't know if I found sales for any of these. This a little rough looking Bull Doll, and I got Ain't It the Truth, the Shannon Sisters, Abner Spector, who wrote this song, Myers, Laverne, Woodall, I'll Hold You Dear, I assume it's just probably regular country. Ooh, it's raining a little bit. Aww. The Druids, half plus name, it's set called The Druids, Man Should Never Cry, and It's a Day. Hey, the sun's out, must be maybe there'll be a rainbow to end my video, man. Larry Mack, The Next Sound You Hear, and If I Had My Way. Looks interesting. Getting rained on here. Uh-oh, now I did it. There's quite a few left in here. I'm probably not going to get through the whole back, so don't worry. Rockabye Your Baby with a Dixie Melody, Jerry Lewis. And then Come Rain or Come Shine. Now, I don't know if this is Jerry Lewis, you know, Jerry's Kids, Jerry Lewis, Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis, but I will find out once I play it. California Strut, Walter Murphy and the Big Apple Band, Fifth of Beethoven's on the other side. Hey, that was written by Walter Murphy. Huh. All right. Once You Understand, the band's called Think, which I thought was cool, but it was didn't end up being really worth much. And then we got an Eric Clapton, that should be for sale, sorry. Lay Down, Sally. And then Rod Stewart, I saw where somebody got 15 for one of these promos. My Way of Giving, same song on the other side, mono, both mono versions. That's weird. And then we got Chinese Checkers by Booker T and the MGs. And I've said before why I like these guys. There's a Cropper and a couple other guys in the Booker T, and they were Blues Brothers. Cropper, Steve Cropper. On the Dark Side, you know, Eddie and the Cruisers by John Caffrey and the Beaver Brown Band. Hollywood, Connie France, I wanted to hear what it sounded like. He's My Dreamboat. Then this one, my favorite Sonny and Cher songs, A Cowboy's Work Is Never Done. Check it out sometime. I can't use it on my videos, got a copyright in the one, I had that little Fisher-Price record player or whatever, and I used a segment on that of it. Partridge Family, I Think I Love You, that was a special song for somebody and me once. Still like the song. For Your Eyes Only, Sheena Easton, James Bond. Electric Prunes, Had Too Much to Dream Last Night. I don't know if that was their song. The songwriters are different on both songs. Lovin', or is it the same? Nope, different. I wanted to hear this song by Freddie Can. Transistor Sister sounds cool. Palisades Park, I think, was maybe a song by a hit by him. Here's Hair by the Cowsills. Nice looking record. Cool label. And then there's a Nut Rocker by Emerson, Lake and Palmer. And the other side's Great Gates of Kiev. Jennifer Warren, Essex. These are ones I think I still have to look them up. Hank Ballard and the Midnighters. It's on King. Might probably doesn't have much value, like I said. Don, Dick and Jimmy. Buddy Knox, Tracy Gould Band, Hurricane Smith. I'm sure I've had that several times, but my memory isn't very good, so I forget what I've looked up sometimes. Sea Train, Jody Sands, The Marvelettes, The Essex, Mary's Vineyard, Claude King, flip side. Same song. Tighten Up Part 1 and Part 2, Archie Bell and the Drills. The Drills. And we got B.B. Jasper, audition copy, I Don't Want to Be Right, Love on the Side, Surfin' Hootenanny. You know that's got to be good. That's why it's in there. I didn't look that up, but I'm going to play it. And Calling Mr. Sandman. It's Mark Langham production, sample copy. A little show on the other side. I don't know if it's a spoken thing, like a comedy record or what. So there you go. Hope you enjoyed. Hope it didn't take too much out of your day. And we will talk again. Bye.